नमस्ते स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम डॉक्टर अजीज मोहम्मद खान फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ फूड एंड बायोटेक्नोलॉजी, फैकल्टी ऑफ एग्रीकल्चर एंड वेटरिनरी साइंस, ज्योति विद्यापीठ वुमेन्स यूनिवर्सिटी जयपुर। टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस अबाउट द टॉपिक रोल ऑफ माइक्रोबायोलॉजी इन एग्रीकल्चर। दिस इज अ चैप्टर बिलोंग्स टू द माइक्रोबायोलॉजी फील्ड। So, what are the role of microorganisms in public health or human health? So, in human body, there are lot of microorganisms. Some of them are in the human body, and some of microorganisms exist on the surface of human body. It means on the skin surfaces. So, human body is a ecosystem which have trillions of bacteria, viruses, fungi. Some are beneficial and some may be pathogenic, but the with organisms which are beneficial are included in the human ecosystem. So we are going to discuss about the beneficial microorganisms which exist on the human body. So first, microbes on the skin. The skin is the outermost part of the human body, and some of the microbes show the symbiotic relationship in the skin, such as these microbes get their nutrition from the human skin as a return gift. They protect us from the harmful microorganisms. So how they protect us? They have specific toxin molecules which acts against another bacterial, another pathogen which are harmful to us. So beneficial is fighting against the harmful bacteria. So this is the major symbiosis relationship. One example of this kind of bacteria, it's Bacillus subtilis, which may be found on the human skin. Another role of these microflora is that they have important role in T cell activation, such as T cell identify these microbes and they identify them cell and non-cell with along with the major histocompatibility complex, and they help T cells to identify some pathogenic bacteria. So this is a very useful role of microbes present on the skin. Next, the microorganisms present in the nasal cavity. Some microbes are also found in the nasal cavity, which play a crucial role in determining the reaction pattern of the mucosal and systemic immune response. The example include Cornibacterium, Oreobacterium, Rhodococcus, Staphylococcus. These microbes can emit out some pathogenic, can remove these pathogenic microbes from the human body using nasal cavity. Next, the microbes found in the mouth oral cavity. So these are the microbes which have shown the symbiotic relationships. They are found in the oral cavity. These are the beneficial microbes. They are also known as the normal oral microflora. Okay, and they are also known as the oral microbiome of the human body, or they are also found in the other animals, which we will discuss in the later part of this video. The oral microbes of oral cavity include Actinobacteria, Bacteriocetes, Themaria, Chlorophexi, Bifidobacteria, and so on, so on. So these microbes of the oral cavity have important role as an antagonistic effect against some pathogenic bacteria, as I have discussed earlier. So antagonistic effect means one microorganism fight for its own existence. It means they have some specific molecules which are known as the antibiotics. So they secrete some toxins which may be harmful for the another pathogenic bacteria, and the pathogenic bacteria may be killed by the beneficial bacteria of a human body which are present in the mouth cavity. So this is known as the antagonistic. Antagonistic means against, fighting to each other so that one beneficial bacteria can kill the pathogenic bacteria is known as the antagonistic effect. Now the microbes in human gut. The microbes of human gut also have important role in the nutrition and defense. They have important role in the digestion of food, absorb nutrients, and they have also an important role in the excretion of waste matter from the human body. So they excrete out the some unnecessary, unusual food material from the body, and they help the human body parts to select the unnecessary food material, the waste materials, which may be non-beneficial, which may be non-required to human body. In intestine, some microbes help in digestion and have important role in fighting against some pathogenic microorganisms. So these are the beneficial microbes which have important role in the human health. They maintain the stability of human health. They maintain the condition of the immune system. So they are very beneficial. Without their symbiosis, without their existence, human cannot exist. They have really very important role for the existence of the human body, the existence of the human himself. Now, microbes in the reproductive tract. So, human reproductive tract is a sensitive part, and they contain a lot of microorganisms and lot of density of microorganisms. And these microorganism communities provide the defense when gametogenesis, pregnancy, and delivery exist. Vaginal microbiota of females play important role in prevention of some diseases, the fight against the bacteria, the fight against bacteria, yeast infection, some sexual transmitted diseases, urinary tract, and human immunodeficiency virus also. So how they protect us? They protect by antagonistic effect. Okay, some microbes such as lactic acid bacteria, these microbes can lower the pH of the body so that the microbes cannot survive. Some microbes cannot survive, the others which are outside bacteria, which are pathogen bacteria, if the pH will be lowered by the lactobacillus, then these pathogen bacteria cannot survive in the vagina and cannot survive and can be killed. If they cannot survive, they cannot grow and they cannot cause any kind of disease. So pH, lowering the pH is an important role of lactic acid bacteria, as they have important role in the defense mechanism. Similarly, the lactic acid bacteria have some also bacteriostatic and bactericidal effect. Bacteriostatic means killing the bacteria, killing the pathogenic bacteria. So this is the bacteriostatic effect. And bactericidal means prevention of their existence. They prevent that any other pathogenic bacteria cannot grow. Another thing is some microbes compete for their digestion, compete for their nutrition. If some pathogenic bacteria arrives in the human body, the beneficial bacteria compete for the food, compete for the nutrition, so that the pathogenic bacteria cannot get any nutrients from the human body and cannot survive and can be died as soon. So some microbes have important in the digestive system. Here are the some examples that such as E. coli, which have important role in the intestine, which have important role in the production of some vitamins such as vitamin K, blood clotting factors, and the lactobacillus example is also have important role in the providing the nutrients to the body parts. Now one more example for digestive health is found in the cows. The rumen of the cows is responsible for the breakdown of the carbohydrates. So if the carbohydrate cannot be breakdown, the cow cannot produce its own food. And it cannot digest the carbohydrates because some cellulose parts are present in the plants, and cows get their nutrition from the plants. They eat grasses. If the grass cannot be digested by the microbes, then these animals cannot survive. So their digestive system also have some useful microbes which digest the cellulose, that is the major part of the cell wall of the bacterial cell of plant cell. So if this cellulose can be digested, the bacteria can survive. So the cows can get their nutrition, and the cows, the animals, and bacteria, similarly to the human, they play symbiosis relationship in which they help each other for their nutrition, for their survival. Similarly, some of microbes produce enzymes which digest the cellulose naturally. Okay, so these are the important role of the microbes. Now the other roles which we can discuss in the role of microbes in the industry. So they are also the part in the production of some industrial importance compounds, some industrial importance products from the microbes. So the first role of microbes is in the production of insulin. Insulin can be produced from the microbes. Next is antibiotic. Antibiotic provide the defense to the human when they get contaminated to any microbial infection. The antibiotic provide the defense to the microbes so that human can get recover as soon as recover. And these antibiotics are produced from the useful microbes. Next, the production of vitamins. Vitamins are also produced from the, we discussed in this video that vitamin K is also produced from the microorganism in the human digestive system, vitamin K. And similarly, some humans who cannot produce these vitamins can, then we can produce these vitamins by industrial processes. Next is the production of some organic acid. Organic acid are also beneficial for the human health and supplementary nutrients. Next is enzymes. Some enzymes which are beneficial can also be produced from the microorganism. So what is the process for the production of the useful products from the microbes? Only two procedures are there. The one is fermentation process. These useful products can be produced by the fermentation process, and the other thing is that genetic engineering or recombinant DNA technology. And so these useful products can be isolated, can be produced from genetic engineering and recombinant technology. So our lecture is over here, and next we will meet in the another video.